Oh my god, the audacity of this game. I cannot even begin to explain how annoyed I am. Oh my lord. Okay, so today we're going to be doing a Razaria build video, and we're going to be getting into her. She got a few builds I think she can go for, being like, you know, sub DPS, main DPS, all of that. So we're going to be going over those. But real quick, I just want to show you guys what just happened to me, right? I should have been recording. I don't know why I wasn't recording. But I did not think that this was going to happen. Okay, so if you guys saw my last video, which if you haven't seen my last video, go check it out. I'll have a little card in top right, link into it, or you can just check my channel. It's basically where I spent 125, I think it was 125, it was like 120 to 130 rolls trying to get as many constellations as I can for Razaria. And I got two. Don't we have a job? Not even two on one account, I got one on two different accounts. So I have a C0 Razaria. Okay, 130 rolls. 130. And I got a C0. Mad, right? But yesterday, I had a few Primal Gems. I was like, you know what? Let me just wish, right? Forget that, first of all. I randomly got a Diluc. Okay. And I'm like, oh, great. Cool. And then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 later, the worst part is I have still yet to get any more Razaris. How does that mean? I got 2 5 stars within 5 rolls, right? So I now got a C1 Totalia and a C1 Diluc, which, you know, it just makes them better main DPSs, so I can't complain that much. But bro, that makes no sense. Oh, I don't know whether to call that lucky or to call that unlucky, because I got Diluc and Totalia, two of the best main DPSs, and now I got them C1, which just makes them even better. But at the same time, I didn't want them, so, and I wanted Razaria, and I'm not getting the person I want, so it's unlucky, but it's also very lucky, so, you know, mad. All right. Let's get into these builds, yeah? Okay, so today we are here to talk about the one and only Miss Razaria. And she has two builds, right? She got two builds that she can go for, but she has three different roles. She can either be a physical damage build or a cryo damage build. The role that she can play is main DPS, sub DPS, or a support, like a quick in and out burst kind of support. The physical damage build is typically for the main DPS, but it can be used for the sub DPS. And the cryo damage build is typically used for their quick in and out burst kind of support, but can also be used for the sub DPS build as well. So let's get straight into the build. The way I play her is basically as kind of a mix between the quick in and out burst support, but also a sub DPS. So I'll show you what I have in mind. My one, she is at 1800 attack with not the greatest, I think 50% crit rate and 150% crit damage. I think that's somewhat decent. You would preferably want it to be like the crit rate be half the crit damage, but this is actually still decent. Anything above 40% crit rate with anything above like 90% crit damage is where you would want to be at. So 50% with 150% damage is decent, I'd like to say. Obviously, it could be, the crit rate could be better, but with what I got, I think this is okay. So the way I have her built is for, like I said, the cryo damage. But I'll tell you guys what you need to change. Again, quick rundown. Physical damage build, you want to use Dragon Spine Spear or Crescent Pike. I don't know about the 5-star options, I'll be honest. I don't know if there's any 5-star Olams that will give you a physical damage bonus or not. If there are, let me know in the comments. So basically, you just want a weapon that will build physical damage bonus, and then on the artifacts, you would want to go either 2-piece Gladius Finale and a 2-piece Bloodstained Chivalry, or maybe you could go with a 4-piece Gladiators, but I would go for the 2-piece Gladiators and 2-piece Bloodstained. And then you want to build as much attack, crit rate, crit damage, and your goblet will need to be a physical damage cup. Last but not least, make sure that your normal attack is your main priority when it comes to talents. Then the sub DPS build, you want to go for crit rate or crit damage if you have god artifacts and you can get away with not having to get a weapon that has crit rate or crit damage. Then you could go with the dragon spine or the press and pike to increase the physical damage as a sub DPS. And then artifacts, you would want to run either a Blizzard Strayer 4-piece if you are going for more of the cryo route. But if you want a balance between the cryo but also decent main physical, then you can run 2-piece Blizzard and 2-piece Bloodstained. And then again, same substats, crit rate, crit damage and attack, but goblet will be cryo damage. And then your talents, you can decide whether you want the normal or your burst to be your main priority. And then finally, the quick in and out burst support cryo, don't really know how to call it, no easy way of saying it. You want crit rate, crit damage, all of that, because the main attack and main physical attack, just it doesn't matter to you. So crit rate, crit damage, anything that you can get, perfect for her. And then artifacts, I would say 4-piece Blizzard Strayer or 2-piece Blizzard Strayer and 2-piece Noblesse Obliged. That is probably the better route to go. And then it will be same as before, crit rate, crit damage, attack percentage, whatever you can get as your substats, and then a cryo damage bonus pop for your goblet. And then your talent, you're going to want to make sure that your burst is your highest priority.
Yeah.
That is that for Rosaria. She is actually very, very good. Like, the potential she has is higher than my Ganyu. Obviously, Ganyu is broken in that she does like 30k damage, even though, okay, relax. Whoa. What is with those noises? Yeah, she's not a Ganyu. Don't get me wrong. She's not Ganyu by any means, okay? But nobody is, to be fair. But she does do very, very decent damage. I haven't tried her as the physical damage build, so I don't know what her physical damage, her main DPS potential is like. But as a sub DPS, she just works. And this game just focuses so much on like team synergy and using everyone's different elements to your advantage. So running a Bennett with a Fissure, with a Rosaria and a Tartaglia, it's nuts. I'll set them on fire with Bennett, then Fissure's burst, and then get the overload, then they'll get electrified, use Rosaria, and then they become, what's the word, what's cryo on Electra? I don't remember what it's called, but that effect goes on to play. Then they get frozen because I use Tartaglia and make them wet. Pause. But you know what I mean. Yeah, so it's mad. You just have to make sure you got the team composition correct, because you know this game just focuses highly on all of that. But yeah, that is the Rosaria build basically. Let me know if this helped you guys in the comments below. If you think there's anything that I should change, let me know again in the comments. And you know, smash that thumbs up if it helped you out. Subscribe, help the channel grow, help other people see this video. And yeah, until the next one, I'll see you guys then. Take care. Peace.